Hi there. So, how did the mock 14 go for you? I hope you are learning from every mock and moving towards the kind of percentiles that you are targeting. So, let's go ahead and discuss the VARC section of mock 14 together. So, let's go ahead and dive into our first passage. Now, this passage talks about a person called Cortina, and then it refers to her work. And it starts off well, right? It goes ahead and tells us that her work is philosophically rich. But then thereafter it subsequently lists down certain areas of disagreement, right? So she says, okay, people have this aversion towards poor because of fear, insecurity. But then the very next paragraph says that there are a couple of other factors which are equally important. And then you have yet another factor in the third paragraph, and then one more factor in the fourth paragraph. And thereafter, you have this Australian example where you are once again bringing in nuances. So it's not that everybody dislikes poor all across. There are further subdivisions that are backed by some studies, some research. So that's what this really focuses on. So let's go ahead and pick up the first question. Which of the following statements, if true, would weaken the author's claim that Cortina's work is questionable? So I think by now we know that the author is calling Cortina's work questionable for three big reasons. So let us go ahead and check which one of these weakens it. A, poor people who receive financial benefits are disrespected. Hey, this is something which is mentioned in the last two paragraphs of the passage, that those who are on benefits are looked down upon. So A is consistent. If anything, this will go on to strengthen the claim. B, the responses of the people towards the poor borders on apathy. Yes, once again, if you look at the second paragraph, the author says that indifference and neglect are at least equally powerful as compared to fear, etc. So that apathy is essentially what? Indifference. So this also supports what the author has said. So it's not going to weaken the author's claim. It'll strengthen. C, people do not generally have an aversion towards the deserving poor. This is once again consistent with the ideas that are mentioned in the fourth paragraph, where you divide them into deserving and non-deserving. The ones who are deserving, you don't hate them. The ones that you feel are not deserving, you hate them. And then if they are also on benefits, you hate them more. Okay, so but this is consistent with whatever is stated, particularly in the fourth paragraph, so this also strengthens. Okay, D, a recent study found that all poor people are regarded as deserving. Ooh, the author here has presented the fact that poor can be divided into two categories by people, and those categories determine the attitude of the people. If D is true, then the author's claim of those different categories that vanishes. And therefore, because it contradicts a major part of author's argument, this will definitely weaken it. And that is why our answer to question number one should be option D. Let's dive into our next question. According to the author, which one of the following statements is debatable about Cortina's hypotheses? So, what are the hypotheses presented by Cortina? Actually, there is only one core hypothesis, and that is fear and aversion. Right? Now, if I look at A, Cortina's philosophy is more or less at variance with that of the authors. So, where is the hypothesis in A? Where is the hypothesis that Cortina has made? Where is that assumption? Nowhere. B, the author regards Cortina's work as deficient and fragmentary. Yes, this can be inferred, but then where is the hypothesis that is debatable? So A and B, because they do not even mention any hypothesis, you can rule it out. And even otherwise, the author felt fear and aversion, sorry, Cortina felt fear and aversion are the causes, and the author goes and lists down three different reasons. So that fear and aversion basically is what we are kind of debating. Okay, then C, people have an amoral antipathy towards the poor. Absolutely. This is something that is backed up by the passage. Okay, so people have an amoral antipathy towards the poor. So there is no morality involved, whereas the author subsequently in the last 3 to 4 paragraphs tells us that no. There can be a morality involved, and then there are all of those divisions. It's not that they are treated as a monolith and you hate them because of your fear and aversion. So C is definitely one of those core points. D, people's response towards the poor is one of fear and contempt. Ah, yes, this is the author's, this is Cortina's hypothesis, yes. But then this is a hypothesis that the author has not debated. If you go back to the second paragraph, author accepts fear and contempt, okay? But then he says that apart from fear and contempt, you also have indifference and neglect, right? So indifference and neglect are equally powerful. So that does not mean that the author does not agree to fear and contempt. That's his way of saying that, okay, fear and contempt are factors, but then there are more factors involved as well. And therefore, D can also be ruled out. So I think even through elimination, we could easily arrive at option C. So for question number 2, our answer is C. And with that, let's dive into the next question. 3. All of the following inferences from the passage are false except. So the one which is true is going to be our answer. Or maybe the one that is can't say, because false except simply means not false. So let's see. A. Cortina's work was comprehensive and accurate. Well, the author has gone on to tell us that it is not accurate. So this is false. Cortina's philosophy was congruent with that of authors. False. The author and Cortina disagree. So they are not in agreement. C. Cortina's work was remiss in discussing poverty according to the author. Yes. The author has pointed out the shortcomings in Cortina's work. So it is remiss. It is missing out on certain things. This is true. The author disagrees entirely with Cortina's perception of the poor. Disagrees, yes, but is that entire? No. Author agrees that fear and contempt are factors. But then he goes on to say that there are other factors involved as well. So it is because of this entirely that we can label it false. And that is why our answer to question number 3 should be option C. And with that, let's dive into the last question based on the passage. What is the author trying to accomplish in this particular passage? So can I say that this is basically a main idea question? He's trying to tell us that Cortina's theory about poor is deficient in some way. Well, let's go ahead and check. A. Chastise Cortina's faulty hypotheses about the poor. Now, you know, chastise is to criticize someone severely. Okay. I think a synonym can be attack, revile. So author disagrees, yes, but the disagreement has been civil, academic, polite. Chastise is way too negative a word to be used here. Okay, let's have a look at B. Highlight flaws in Cortina's work with regard to her polarized version of the poor. Where is the polarized version of the poor talked about in this particular passage? I think that Cortina's work does not mention any polarized version of the poor. In fact, it is the author who claims that her work is polarized. So it's not the Cortina's work which is mentioning it. And therefore, B can also be ruled out. Okay, then have a look at C. Give reasons as to why he feels Cortina's philosophy is deficient and debatable. Yes, he cites 3 reasons plus some support. D, point out similarities. There is pointing out differences and not similarities. So D can also be eliminated. So the best answer choice for question number 4 is once again option C for us. So that takes care of our first passage.